Hello everyone, so today we will talk about this question, remove palindromic subsequences. So let us read the description what they are saying. So given a string S consisting only of a letter A and B, in a single step you can remove one palindromic subsequence from S, okay, and return the minimum number of steps to make the given string empty. A string is a subsequence of a given string, okay, if it is generated by deleting some characters of a given string without changing its order. A string is called a palindrome if it is one that reads the same backward as well as forward. Okay, so what the question is saying is, so first we are given a string, okay, and consists of only a small letter A or B, only two characters, okay, and we need to find, basically we need to remove all the palindromic subsequences from this string to make it empty string, okay. Basically we need to remove all A's and all B's, and we need to remove in such a way that we can remove at a time, we can remove only one palindromic subsequences, okay. For example, in this case you can see A B A B A, okay. From here when you see towards left, when you see towards right, you will be getting the same thing, okay. When you read from here to from left to right and from right to left, you will be having the same, okay, you will be having the same string. So that's why this is a palindromic, obviously already this is palindromic subsequence, that's why we are returning one, because we can remove this whole string at once, okay. Now when we talk about this A B B A A B B, okay, basically, so first what we can do is a single character is a palindrome itself, okay, because when you read for A from left, from left or from right, basically it will be same only, so that's why we can remove this in one step, okay. Now we can see this is again palindrome BB. Now we can see we can remove this also in one, so total how many will be there, total two will be there, okay. And now third case can be, now let us check this case, what is this BA A B B, okay. Now what we can do is, there can be many ways. So first is what we can do is, we can remove this B first, and now that will take one step, and now we can see we can remove this B A A B B B A A B in second step. So there will be two operations, so total give us two, so the output for this is two. Let us see, let me erase all this. So for B A A B B we are getting two. Now for empty string, what we will be getting, we will be getting 0 only, okay. So for this, this basically 0, output is 0 for this one. Now talking about the constraints, we have length up to 10 to the power 3 and S only consists of letters A and B, okay. So only A and B. Now let us talk about the intuition. Now when you closely see the description and only when you see these constraints, S is only a letters of A and B, you can come to know that suppose A A A B B A, something like this, any random thing. Now you can see what can be the maximum steps you can use to remove this, basically to remove all A's and all B to get to 0, basically to remove all of them. So you can see maximum can be 2. How it can be 2? When you see, first when you remove all A's will be forming a palindromic subsequence because it is all A's, so that's why that will be first step. And when you, after removing this, becomes like this B B B. Now we can remove this all B's, so there can be only maximum values, maximum value is 2, okay. So minimum value is 0, maximum value is 2, and the other value is 1, okay. So in what case we need to return 1, okay. So if the substring or if the string is already a palindrome, okay, for example we have seen the first case A B A B A, okay. Now this is already a palindrome, okay. So in this case we can remove all the strings in only one step, so that is what we need to return in this case, okay. Now there are only three possible results, 0, 1 and 2, okay. Now if you can try by yourself, then that will be best. So you can just try to pause the video and try to write the code by yourself. I hope I have cleared most of the this basic thinking or basic intuition. Now let us see the code here. So here is the code. In this, what we are checking, if the size is 0, then we are returning 0. If it is palindrome, we are returning 1, else we are returning 2. Okay. Now function for palindrome is very simple. We'll start from iteration from left. We'll start from basically we'll run this while loop. Okay. L will be the starting and right will be the R will be the basically s dot size minus 1, which will be the last. Now we'll start in the iteration from left and we'll move left pointer towards right and right towards left. Okay. And we'll check if both are not equal, then we'll return false. If this loop gets over, then we are returning true, means they are having equal strings. Okay. Basically that is palindrome. Okay. So that's it for this video. This is the basic code. If you like the video, then just go and like the video and subscribe for the latest updates from this channel.